My name is Mahendra Parmar and today I'm going to talk about Train 10,000 Teachers Training Program under the National Mission on Education through ICT. Recently, we have got the approval from Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya. So all our future workshops will be run under Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya National Mission for Teachers and Training. Before I talk about the T10KT thing, I will just give you the scenario in India. The thing is, in last two decades, it is observed that there are increase in number of engineering institutions and students opting for engineering courses. But the thing is that there is a lack of access to good quality education. If you see, there are only about 20% of engineering institutions as per our survey, they are employable at the industry level. And two-thirds of the universities, they are like middling or in poor standard. So there is a urgent need for skill enhancement for teachers in different subjects and other less explored areas. And the problem is, like, we cannot train all of them because the number of teaching fraternity is on higher side. So we have come up with a T10KT model. We started this initiative in 2009, obviously by Professor D.B. Fatak. Initially, we started with EduSat facility. It was done through satellite. We had very limited number of remote center in this EduSat facility, as it is a expensive stuff to have it, and only few remote centers could afford it. So later we moved towards this AVU thing, which is connected through internet, and it has a wider reach. We can cover more number of participants using AVU. We have conducted this teacher training program in two phases. Phase one was train 1,000 teachers training program, and in phase two, that started in 2012, it was train 10,000 teachers training program. In 2012, IIT Kharagpur also extended the hand and they become our partners. They are also conducting a training program for teachers, just like us. So why T10KT model is effective? In this T10KT model, we can train large number at one go. Like, you can imagine training 10,000 teachers at one go is a very big thing. And otherwise, like, if you call everybody to IIT Bombay or to IIT Kharagpur, we could only train about 300 or 400 maximum. But in this, we could cover the larger number of people and teachers. We could do empowerment of students and teachers both through synchronous and asynchronous instruction. And the thing is, like, since T10KT uses AVU facility and use of ICT is done optimally, like, instructors have to do very minimal changes to give this live lectures. And last but not the least, it was very cost effective. So how we conduct the STTPs? IIT faculty, they decide on the topic on core engineering subject. Then we decide on the common syllabus. We have the coordinators workshop first, which I'll talk about this later. In the main STTP, we conduct the synchronous distance mode of teaching, that is through AVU. Then various tools have been used, like Moodle, IIT Bombay X, flipped classroom like SurSet, and all of these contents later on after the STTP, they are generated in open source for free download. So till now we have conducted 39 STTPs and covered different domains like computer science, mechanical engineering, civil engineering, electrical engineering, physics, and some interdisciplinary course also, like research methodology, solar photovoltaics, and green building awareness. I forgot to add technical communication, which was well appreciated all across. We have about 1,35,000 participants so far from this 357 remote centers. And I just would like to add that there are 4,060 unique institutions who have participated so far. So what is a remote center? Remote center is an engineering institute which should have a good infrastructure. AVU is done through online mode. We need an institute who can facilitate this thing. So we need an engineering institute. They should have this facility, AVU equipment, and some minimum a separate lab is required. They should have proximity to other colleges also, so that when the main STTP is conducted, the nearby colleges can come and attend this program sitting there. Academics means how many departments they have and the number of faculty which are. So this is the map of the remote center. We have 357 remote centers across 26 states and 2 union territories. There are a few states which we are yet to cover, which is Bihar, Nagaland, and some northeast states. So the methodology is, like, we make the remote centers first, just like I showed you here. We make the remote centers. We request the remote center to have people at the remote center. There are, like, remote center coordinators. He is the overall in charge of that remote center. He generally lies between their institute and IIT Bombay whenever the workshop is announced, he generally makes sure that their subject experts are being nominated and they do the registration online. So RCC is remote center coordinator. The workshop coordinator is subject expert who comes to the coordinator's STTP and later become the workshop coordinator in the main STTP. And then we have a AVO coordinator. His role is also again very important because he has to make sure that the live transmission continues throughout the workshop. In case of any problem, he has to sort it out as soon as possible. I talked about the people at remote center. So we conduct the coordinator short-term training program 2 months prior to the main STTP. So all of this practice, like to conduct the one workshop, make sure that that plan is done 6 months prior to the main STTP. So 2 months before the main STTP, we conduct the coordinator's STTP, where the subject expert from this remote centers, they come to IIT Bombay. They are being trained the methodology, like how to go about it in the main STTP. They are being taught like what all things will be covered. And later we discuss the syllabus with them and the syllabus is finalized so that in the main STTP, all these topics are equivalent all in the remote centers. And then later we conduct the main STTP. In the main STTP, the nearby colleges and the faculty, they assemble at this remote centers. They attend the workshop here. And if they have any query, the workshop coordinators helps them out. And they can also do the interaction with IIT Bombay using AVU chat, the Moodle discussion forum, or IIT Bombay platform discussion forum. So this is the process flow. In this, we conduct the coordinators STTP, like I told you earlier. We coordinate with the remote centers first. Then this remote centers do their registration. They become the prospective workshop coordinator. Then we conduct the sessions at IIT Bombay. Of course, there is a certification given at the end of the workshop. And later we conduct the main STTP. In this, the nearby faculty attend the workshop here. Then the live video session is conducted using AVU. And real-time audit from IIT Bombay happens simultaneously just to check like all the centers are online or not. And after the short-term training program, we issue the certificate. There are some criteria also which instructors decide. After once this is decided, we do the filtration of a certificate. Certificates are distributed to these remote centers, and later the audio video edit is done and then uploaded online. So this is a snapshot which I'll show you. So faculty from IIT Bombay is delivering live lecture, and in the second slide on the right side of yours, faculty from IIT Bombay is interacting with one of the remote center. And some interesting findings which we have seen, like 91% to 92%, they have indicated the high perception of learning and satisfaction. So which is a very good thing for us, like all the content which are given from IIT Bombay, they are being useful and they are using it in their day-to-day teaching. And we have seen that 19,353 teachers, they participate more than one workshop. Teachers are basically very busy in their academic schedule, but still they take some time out for this workshop and they attend the program. Not only teachers, we have seen remote centers also, like they participate continuously, like 33% of 357 remote centers. They are continuously participating and they are the most recurring remote centers in our workshops. So in 2015, we have launched this IIT BombayX platform through OpenEDX only. And we have been conducting MOOCs and blended MOOCs in this platform. In phase two only, like Train 10,000 Teachers Training Program, we have also added the blended MOOCs here. In the blended MOOCs, we conduct the face-to-face and online segment is also there. So suppose if we announce for the 2-week IST STTP, they don't have to physically attend this workshop at the remote center for 2 weeks. Now they just have to attend only for 1 week, and rest of the weeks have been, actually it's an online thing, so 5 weeks equivalent is called as 1 week of actual work. So we give them the online activity, that is the MOOC part, and they have to come for the face-to-face interaction at the remote center. So this we call it as a blended MOOC. We have not only done the blended MOOCs for teachers, but we have done the blended MOOCs for students also. It's limited to autonomous institutions only. This course is, we have announced this in 2015, July. We have conducted the semester-long course for this autonomous institutions, where the teachers of this autonomous institutions, they become the mentor of the students. The students who score this marks in IIT BombayX, their scores are being considered in their internal grading. So how these STTPs are useful now for larger audience, like all the contents, it's available in open source. Like it is available in both video and document format. And of course, teachers are getting IIT Bombay style teaching learning. To know more about the NMEICT thing, you can visit our www.iit.iitb.ac.in/NMEICT website. Thank you.